Good morning. Let's learn about the mass spectrometer.
Flippin' physics.
In a mass spectrometer, you have two different main parts, the velocity selector and the deflection chamber. Let's start with the velocity selector. In the velocity selector, we have a uniform magnetic field and a uniform electric field oriented at right angles relative to one another. Just so you know, this is also sometimes referred to as a crossed field. In our example, we have a top plate with a positive electric charge and a bottom plate with a negative electric charge. As we have discussed several times before, this creates a uniform electric field which is oriented downward. There is also a uniform magnetic field which is oriented into the screen. We send a stream of charged particles horizontally into the velocity selector. Bo, assuming the charged particle is positive and moving horizontally to the right, what forces are acting on the positively charged particle?
Well, the positive charge is moving to the right. It will experience a Coulomb force caused by the electric field. Because the charge is positive, the force from the electric field will be in the direction of the electric field. The positive charge will also experience a magnetic force caused by the fact it is moving through a magnetic field. We need to use the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the magnetic force. Luckily, I am already not too cool, and I have already limbered up. So, point the fingers of my right hand to the right with the direction of the velocity. Curl my fingers into the screen because that is the direction of the magnetic field. And my thumb points up, which is in the direction of the magnetic force acting on this positive charge.
And Billy, what will the directions of those forces be if the charge instead has a negative charge?
If the charge is negatively charged, the electric force will be opposite the direction of the electric field, which is upward. And using the right-hand rule again, velocity and fingers to the right, curl fingers into the screen with the magnetic field, thumb points up in the direction of the magnetic force of a positive charge. However, this is a negative charge, so the direction of the magnetic force is opposite the up direction, which is down. So a negative charge has the same forces acting on it as a positive charge, only the directions of the forces are switched.
Correct. Thank you both. Bobby, please sum the forces in the y direction on the positive charge.
Newton's second law in the y direction. Well, net force in the y direction equals, for the positive charge, the magnetic force minus the electric force. The net force equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. We know the charge is moving horizontally, so the acceleration in the y direction equals zero. That means the magnitudes of the magnetic force and electric force are equal. And it actually does not matter if the charge is positive or negative, because the acceleration in the y direction is zero, so either way, the magnitudes of the two forces will be equal. The magnitude of the magnetic force equals charge times velocity times magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the directions of the velocity and the magnetic field. The electric force equals charge times the electric field. And
everybody brought charge to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
The angle between the direction of the velocity of the charge and the direction of the magnetic field is 90 degrees, and the sine of 90 degrees is 1. So the velocity of the charge is equal to the ratio of the electric field to the magnetic field.
Cool.
Correct. Cool. Realize this means that only charges with a constant velocity equal to the ratio of the electric field to the magnetic field will move through the velocity selector with a constant horizontal velocity, which is why it is called the velocity selector. The only charges which make it all the way through the velocity selector all have the same velocity, which is equal to the electric field divided by the magnetic field. After the velocity selector, the charges which are moving at a constant horizontal velocity enter the deflection chamber. The only field in the deflection chamber is the same magnetic field which is in the velocity selector. Bo, please determine what happens now.
Sure. The only force acting on the charged particles will be the magnetic force. As the charges enter the deflection chamber, the magnetic force on a positive charge will be up, and the magnetic force on a negative charge will be down. We already figured that out, so... However, the charges will not move in straight lines in the deflection chamber, duh, because the magnetic force acting on each charge will always be perpendicular to the velocity of each charge. The charges will move in a circular path, with positive charges following an upward circular path and negative charges following a downward circular path.
Well done, Bo. Billy, please analyze what happens to a positive charge in the deflection chamber, which moves along a circular path with radius of curvature uppercase R.
Certainly. Because the positive charge is moving in a circle, let's sum the forces in the in direction. The only force acting inward is the magnetic force, and the acceleration in the in direction is centripetal acceleration. The magnetic force, again, is charge times velocity times magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the direction of the velocity and the direction of the magnetic field. And that angle is always 90 degrees, and the sine of 90 degrees equals 1. For centripetal acceleration, do we use tangential velocity or angular velocity? We already have an equation for the linear tangential velocity of the charges, so let's use tangential velocity squared over radius for centripetal acceleration. And
everybody brought one velocity to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
We can substitute electric field divided by magnetic field in for velocity. Rearranging the equation a bit gives us mass times electric field equals charge times radius times the square of the magnetic field. But what am I solving for, Mr. P?
Please solve for the ratio of the mass to the charge of the particle.
Okay. Mass over charge equals radius times magnetic field squared, all divided by electric field.
Thank you, Billy. The mass spectrometer is a tool for determining the ratio of the mass to the charge of a charged particle. And we also know the velocities of these charged particles. It is a very useful tool, especially for reviewing physics concepts. But imagine how useful this could be for learning information about new particles. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.